Welcome to another FAR walkthrough video from SuperfastCPA. I'm Logan, and in today's video, we're going to be going over FAR Area 3. This is Section D. This is an application topic. Calculate the income tax expense and current taxes payable slash receivable. And we're going to be doing that the SuperfastCPA way, which is diving straight into the questions. If you don't know much about our strategies, that is one of our main strategies, and you can learn more about SuperfastCPA if you go to superfastcpa.com and sign up for our free one-hour webinar training. We will teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam, again, for free, in 1 hour, and after that, you're going to want to learn more, so also make sure you check out becoming a SuperfastCPA Pro member, because SuperfastCPA Pro members get access to the full 10-question versions of these YouTube videos. So I make 5 questions on YouTube, but SuperfastCPA Pro members get access to the full 10-question videos so they can get a little bit more practice and a little bit more understanding. So if you like this, again, make sure you check out becoming a SuperfastCPA Pro member. With all that, let's dive straight into the questions. All right, here we are at question one. And one thing I want to say as we're diving into these questions, these aren't extremely difficult questions. This is kind of a building block video because in the next video, we're going to be talking about book and tax differences. And that's a little bit more difficult in my opinion, but you kind of have to have this base of how to figure out tax expense and tax payable and things like that. So again, these are not super difficult questions, but it's a good base for the next video. So let's go ahead and dive into this. One thing that we always like to point out is to read the last part of the question first, so that you can have context for what you're dealing with. This might seem silly in the moment, like when you're dealing with a lot of the same questions, similar questions, but this is a very good strategy for test day because on test day, you have no idea what you're going to be seeing. So you want to be able to read the last part of the sentence or the question first so that you know what you're dealing with right away, and then you can read through the rest of the question and already know kind of what you're looking for. So again, that's what we always do. So let's start. What is the current tax expense for Mornwell Corporation? So let's go up to the top. Mornwell Corporation reports a pre-tax income of $600,000 for the current year. The following items are included in their financial data. They add non-taxable interest income for $12,000. They add non-deductible entertainment expenses for $8,000. Taxable income for the year after adjusting for these items is $596,000. The corporate income tax rate is 28%. So again, with all that information, what is the current tax expense for Mornwell Corporation? Now, to be honest, this is a pretty easy question. You might get a little bit confused by what do I do with the non-taxable or the non-deductible, but really the answer is really easy. So if you don't already know the answer, that's okay. Let's go ahead and look at the answer together and you'll see that this is a pretty easy question. All right, here we are. The answer is B, $166,880. That's the current tax expense. Again, it's really simple. Let's read through this. The current tax expense is calculated based on taxable income, not pre-tax financial income. So we use the $596,000 of taxable income, not the $600,000 of pre-tax income. And as I said, pretty easy because literally it's already given to us. The taxable income is the $596,000. So these were kind of just thrown in there to maybe make you a little bit confused and to kind of show how we got from $600,000 to $596,000, but that is the taxable income. So we just take this taxable income, multiply it by the tax rate, and that gives us $166,880 of current tax expense. That's the current portion that they owe in the current year. And just to point out how we got there, the non-taxable interest income of $12,000 is excluded from taxable income because it's not taxable, so they're not going to tax that income. And the non-deductible entertainment expenses of $8,000 are added back to pre-tax income to calculate taxable income because you can't deduct those. Those can't count as expenses when it comes to taxes. So you add back the expenses. So you subtract $12,000, add $8,000, and that gives you $596,000, which again was already provided. So that's why you read the last part of the question first, because you read this last part, you know what you're looking for, and as you're reading through this, boom, you already realize, oh, I have the taxable income and the income tax rate. Oh, okay, I can easily do the calculation. So that's why we do that. Let's go ahead and go to the next question now. All right, here we are at question two. What is the income tax payable for Brightwell Enterprises at year end? Brightwell Enterprises reports a taxable income of $450,000 for the current year. The corporate income tax rate is 30%. The company made estimated tax payments of $120,000 during the year. So again, with all that information, what is the income tax payable for Brightwell Enterprises at year end? Now, if you have no idea how to calculate income tax payable, again, this isn't too difficult. At least this question isn't super difficult. So if you have an idea, go ahead and pause the video and try to calculate this yourself. But if you want to go ahead and look at the answer together, that's okay. We'll go ahead and look at the answer together now. All right, here we are. The answer is A, $15,000. So let's go ahead and go through this explanation. Step one, we want to calculate the total tax liability, and that would be the taxable income multiplied by the tax rate. And if you'll notice, that's the same calculation as we had before. So tax liability can be the same as the taxable expense. So $450,000 multiplied by 30% gives you $135,000 of tax liability. Step two, we compare that tax liability to the amount of tax payments that they've already made. So $135,000 less the $120,000 that they've already paid. So that means that they've already paid $120,000 of the tax liability. So there's still $15,000 left that needs to be paid. So that is the income tax payable that they still owe after the estimated payment. So that is the income tax payable in this situation, $15,000. All right, let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question three. What is Brookfield Corporation's income tax receivable at year end? Let's go up to the top. Brookfield Corporation reported a taxable income of $300,000 for the current year. The company's corporate income tax rate is 25%. Throughout the year, Brookfield made estimated tax payments totaling $85,000. After reviewing its financial records, Brookfield confirmed that its taxable income and tax liability were correctly calculated. So with all that information, we have to figure out what the income tax receivable is at year end. So this is a little bit different than income tax payable, but pretty much similar idea. Now, I think that you could probably figure this out based off the previous question. So go ahead, pause the video, do the calculation yourself, and when you're ready, come back. We will look at the answer together. All right, here we are. The answer is D, $10,000. So let's go ahead and walk through this explanation. Step one, calculate the total tax liability. So again, similar thing. We calculate how much liability there is supposed to be based off the taxable income and the tax rate. So $300,000 multiplied by 25% gives you $75,000. Now we go to step two, we compare that tax liability to the estimated payments. They actually paid $85,000 compared to the actual amount that they needed to pay, which was $75,000. So they paid $10,000 more than they needed to. So they are able to have this as an income tax receivable because again, they overpaid. So they might be able to get that money back or be able to use it in some other way towards taxes, maybe in the next year or something like that. So that's how you calculate the income tax receivable. Now let's go to the next question. All right, here we are at question four. What is the income tax expense for Skyline Publishing? Let's go up to the top. Skyline Publishing reports a pre-tax financial income of $350,000 for the current year. The following items are included in its financial statements. Life insurance premiums on key employees, $8,000. Fines related to late filing of regulatory documents, $6,000. Tax depreciation exceeds book depreciation by $20,000. And Skyline is subject to a corporate income tax rate of 30%. So with all that, we have to figure out the income tax expense. Again, I think this is pretty simple, and based on the questions that we've done so far, you probably could figure out or get pretty close to figuring out the correct answer. So go ahead, pause the video, think through these different things and how you think they would affect the income to get to taxable income, and when you're ready, come back, we will look at the answer together. All right, here we are. The answer is B, $103,200. That is the income tax that we calculated from this. Let's go through this. Step one, we have to identify the adjustments that you have to do to the pre-tax financial income. So with the life insurance premiums, just letting you know, and by the way, we're not really diving super deep into these in this video, just because again, this is FAR. And also we're going to talk a little bit more about book to tax differences and things like that in the next video. But you know, we kind of have to look at them a little bit here as well. So life insurance premiums is a book tax difference because for tax purposes, you can't deduct life insurance premiums where the company is the beneficiary. So you add back that $8,000 that they spent as an expense. The fines, these are non-deductible for tax purposes, so you add them back as well for $6,000. And then the tax depreciation can be higher than book depreciation based on accelerated tax depreciations that are available. So the tax depreciation was higher by $20,000, so we subtract that from the pre-tax income. So taxable income equals that $350,000 of pre-tax income plus the $8,000 of life insurance premiums that are not deductible, and the $6,000 in fines that are not deductible. And then we subtract the $20,000 of depreciation that is higher for tax purposes. And that gets us to $344,000 of taxable income. So with that, again, we come down here, multiply the taxable income by the tax rate. $344,000 multiplied by 30% gives us $103,200. And that is the income tax expense in this situation. So again, not too difficult, not a super difficult concept. But again, we kind of have to do this video to be able to go into the next video where we're going to talk a little bit more about complicated things like deferred liabilities, differences in book and tax and things like that. So let's go ahead and go to the next question. All right, here we are at question five. What is Westland Interiors' effective tax rate for the year? So let's go up to the top. Westland Interiors reports the following for the current year. They had income before taxes of $600,000. They had proceeds from life insurance on a key executive for $20,000. They had non-deductible fines for regulatory violations for $15,000. They had tax depreciation that exceeds the book depreciation by $10,000, and the corporate income tax rate is 28%. With all that, again, what is the effective tax rate for the year? So this is a little bit different than what we've been talking about. One last thing that I want you to learn how to calculate. If you know how to do this, great, pause the video and do the calculation yourself. If you don't really know how to do this, maybe give it a guess. or we can go ahead and look at the answer together right now. All right, here we are. The answer is C, 27.3%. That is the amount of effective tax rate here. So let's go through this. Step one, again, you calculate the taxable income like we've been doing. So you adjust for the non-deductible and non-taxable items. So first, we subtract the non-taxable proceeds from life insurance. Now, if you'll remember, the premiums for life insurance are non-deductible, so we can't subtract those expenses, but that also means that the life insurance proceeds are non-taxable. So we subtract the $20,000 of life insurance proceeds from the taxable income. So that gets us to $580,000 of taxable income. Then we add back the non-deductible fines. Again, you can't deduct fines for tax purposes, so you add the $15,000 back. And then you subtract the excess tax depreciation because the tax depreciation is higher than the book depreciation. So $595,000 less $10,000 gives you $585,000 of taxable income. So now that we have that, we can go calculate the taxable income, or the income tax, excuse me, which again is pretty easy. $585,000 multiplied by 28% gets us $163,800 of tax or income tax. Now with that, we can figure out the effective tax rate. So we go down here. It's a pretty easy calculation. You take the income tax, which is $163,800, and you divide it by the pre-tax income or the income before taxes. So you're not dividing it by the taxable income or anything like that. You're dividing it by the pre-tax income. So $163,800 divided by the $600,000 that we had at the beginning, and that gets us 27.3% of effective tax rate. So the effective tax rate reflects the actual tax burden after accounting for permanent differences between book and taxable income. So it actually shows the real tax burden after you make the adjustments for things like, again, non-taxable proceeds from life insurance or non-deductible fines or things like that. And with that, we've gone over quite a bit in just 5 questions. Before we go any further, let's do one more part of the SuperFast CPA process called Pillar Topics. Now, the idea behind Pillar Topics is as you're going through the questions to learn the material, you will notice the things that keep popping up. You've seen 2 or 3 questions trying to teach you how to calculate the current portion of income tax, or you've seen 2 or 3 questions trying to teach you what is non-deductible and what's non-taxable or things like that. So you take a moment after you've done the questions or even while you're doing the questions and you write down these pillar topics. These are the most important things that you learned, the things that stuck out, and you write them in your own words. And as you're doing this each day, you will be building your own personal repository in your own words of the most important things that you need to know for the exam based on what you learned from the questions. So with all that, let's go ahead and look at the pillar topics for this video. All right, here we are at the pillar topics. Let's go ahead and just dive in. First, for the current tax expense, we calculate that as taxable income multiplied by the corporate tax rate. Taxable income is adjusted for temporary and permanent differences from pre-tax financial income. So again, we get taxable income by doing the tax adjustments, and we're going to talk a lot more about those in the next video. Next, let's talk about the income tax payable. This represents the tax liability based on taxable income minus any estimated tax payments made during the year. So if there are no payments made, the liability would equal the payable amount. So the full amount is payable if you haven't already paid some for the estimated taxes. And kind of a similar thing with the income tax receivable, but on the other end, this occurs when estimated tax payments exceed the calculated tax liability. The excess is recorded as a receivable and reflects an overpayment to be refunded or applied to future taxes. Let's go to the next thing, which is non-taxable and non-deductible items. Again, we're going to talk more about this and deferred assets and liabilities when it comes to taxes in the next video. So we're just kind of doing a brief overview in this video. Items like municipal bond income, which is non-taxable, by the way, reduce taxable income because you can't tax that income, while expenses like fines or penalties, which are non-deductible, increase taxable income because you have to add them back, and that gets you from the pre-tax income to the taxable income. And then finally, the effective tax rate calculation is as follows. You calculate it as total income tax expense divided by the pre-tax financial income. It reflects the actual tax burden on financial income, including the impact of permanent differences. So again, it's kind of showing the actual effect of the taxes on the income for the company. And with all that, we've gone over 5 questions and the pillar topics, and that is it for this video. Again, remember that SuperFast CPA Pro members will get access to the next 5 questions, so they'll get a full 10-question video about this. So if you like this and you like our other products, make sure you check out becoming a SuperFast CPA Pro member. And one of the easiest ways to do that is by going to superfastcpa.com and starting with our free 1-hour webinar training. Make sure you check that out. Make sure you sign up for that because, again, it's 1 hour, it's free, and we will teach you the key ingredients to passing the CPA exam so that you don't waste months or even years of your time failing these exams and wasting all of your money. So again, check out the webinar, check out becoming a SuperFast CPA Pro member, and with all that, I hope that you liked this video. Make sure to like it and leave a comment if you did, and I will see you in the next video.